Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the cage, Connor Nolan!
What we know, so to me it ain't nothing but being true. But now I know, holy high, it's time to rain. It doesn't have to be the way it is, you say it is, just because for the past 20 years, every day it is. But now I know, holy high, it's time to rain. I wanna be able to walk out my front door without worrying about coming in conflict with the law. Cause now I know, holy high, it's time. If I follow him, they'll follow me. I'll speak life into the world that you can see. Cause now I know, holy high, it's time to rain. We get away with everyday shit, but everyday shit catches up to you. When it does, you can't say shit. But now I know, holy high, it's time to rain. If I don't, you will, but I won't, you still. What makes it feel like he got my hell? But now I know. How many more times must we choose to trust these fools? Now I know, holy high, it's
and introducing his opponent, Connor McCarthy!
Connor Nolan in the blue corner, Connor McCarthy in the prep point. We should get the prep point sponsored.
Harley Davidson prep point.
Connor McCarthy in the red corner. Pass it over now to our master of ceremonies, Paul Brown.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is your co-main event of the evening. Five rounds for the super lightweight EUR championship. Introducing first, the challenger fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist representing SBG Nace. Sorry, CMAC, with a record of 4 wins and 3 defeats. Give it up for Connor Nolan! And introducing his opponent, the reigning, defending, the EUR Super Lightweight Champion, representing SBG Nace with a record of 8 wins and 2 defeats. Let's hear it for Connor McCarthy!
Paul, I think Connor's going to win.
The Battle of the Connors. We had the Battle of the Georgies just there. We had the Battle of the Burns earlier. Now it's the Battle of the Connors. Lots of forename and surname anomalies this evening.
Connor McCarthy channeling his early era Tito Ortiz tribute act with these shorts.
Yeah, they're impressive.
Engaged fight shorts. We've seen a couple of pair of Engaged today, actually.
Yep,
fantastic Australian brand.
The left hook and the overhand right or the straight right of McCarthy are really dangerous weapons that have caused problems for a lot of fighters over the last year and a half, 2 years. Nolan's a very good striker himself, though, you know, coming off a good win over Dan O'Sullivan recently. And
come on!
4-3 doesn't really show his true value as a fighter. There's one or two decisions in there that could have easily gone his way. And
yeah, he has some nice feints here. And even though it's given the impression that McCarthy is landing, he's yet to land a fully clean or flush shot, with the exception of a straight left jab.
Yeah.
A lot of the other stuff, nice guard from Nolan. We're talking forearms, shoulders here.
The boxing of McCarthy is very good. Of course, he comes from a boxing background, and you can see it now. That's where he's sort of having the edge a little bit here. McCarthy has more of a Muay Thai style. Fights a lot K1 and Thai and stuff. So, two contrasting styles. Lovely left hand there by Nolan. I might have said McCarthy there has more of a Muay Thai style. I meant Nolan. A slip of the tongue in the cage there too, and mixing everyone up. Too many similar names here.
Let's go, McCarthy, let's go! Fight!
Nolan just overreached there and exposed himself to that left hand, and just fast left hook again by McCarthy.
Yeah!
Slips and rips.
Let's go, McCarthy!
5 rounds here, Andrew Bell. 5 threes, which we haven't seen before.
Let's go!
Interesting, isn't it?
I was going to say, did Connor not do that at the last show? Or am I mixing that up with the announcement that this was going to be done and they both agreed to it straight away?
Yeah,
apologies.
This is the first time.
Let's go!
Great shout from Decky McAleen to do it. Both guys, you'd imagine at some point in the near future, would be debuting in the pro ranks, and then you start fighting for belts there, you know? You've got to get used to winning 3 or 4 rounds rather than just getting by with 2 rounds. And the striking exchanges don't stop. Very interesting first round. First of 5, so it's going to be a test of who can keep up that output over the longer duration. Marathon, not a sprint now tonight. You'd imagine both guys have topped up the gas tank pretty well if they're doing 5 rounds tonight, so they're both probably going to be in good shape for this.
Sorry, as you had said in that first round, it's a good prep. You know, it's good prep for 3 5-minute rounds. I know it's done under a slightly different format and stuff like that, but the same amount of time spent in the cage as if it were to be a professional debut.
There was talk, I heard some debates whether should they not just do 3 5s, but I think from getting insurance and calling it an amateur bout when it's happened, I think there's ramifications on that front, you know what I mean? But being able to do the extra rounds here is a good just test mentally as well as physically for these fighters. Great experience for them to have, know they'll have done it, you know, if they have to go that far. Nolan in his last bout against Dan O'Sullivan probably took a round to find his rhythm, find his distance, find his timing, and eventually did it and won the fight, in my mind, quite impressively. Even though it was a split decision, it was close. The right decision for me in the end was read out. And taking a bit of time to get to the grips with the hands of McCarthy here. Oh, McCarthy flicks up a nice little high kick. A lot of weapon we see him use a lot of. Slip and rip to the body there by Nolan. And run in return by McCarthy.
Connor seems to really be growing in confidence here. It's like the first round we had seen. The first round we had seen We had seen a lot of straight single shots from Conor McCarthy. The second now we've seen a couple of alterations between body and head.
Yeah. It's very impressive so far. Both guys willing to just stand and fight like this, and I'll happily watch five rounds of this. This is excellent technical striking from both sides. And lovely right hand to the body there by McCarthy, setting everything up beautifully with feints or with a jab or...
You know, I feel Nolan's still in this. I feel like he's one shot away from the tide turning. Do you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Conor McCarthy has been an accurate striker in this here.
Let's go!
He's finding a home with those hands, isn't he? And it's very impressive to watch. Some of the best hands in the Irish amateur game, I think.
Here comes a high step.
Nolan just staying right in that pocket. Neither fighter willing to step out of it at the moment. They're both right in each other's faces the whole round. Oh, lovely slip and rip to the body. Up top with a 2-3.
Let's go!
Excellent work by McCarthy again. Flicks out an L teep there just to keep his opponent guessing. It's not just a boxing match. Little fake drop for the knee tap, and then that opens up a gap for the shot up top. This is the right opponent for Conor McCarthy, you would feel, if he wants to put on a display like this, someone who's going to stand and fight him. But as I said, Nolan always in here with a chance. One big shot and it'll change this.
I feel that Conor's settling into his range even more comfortable now, and he's using this as essentially I don't mean to say like a little bit of experience. He's respecting his opponent massively. He's not swarming him. He's not like swinging and missing. You know, the shots are measured. They're calculated.
Yes.
I feel like we've seen him have more stopping power. I feel like in previous fights, we've seen the strikes not just land, but then land and go through.
Yeah.
Do you know? And it nearly feels that he's fighting this way out of respect of Nolan's striking ability, that he can't commit through to those strikes.
Definitely.
Like we've seen on other situations.
He did joke in a post-fight interview, I think it was possibly after his last bout, that, you know, he's becoming a bit of a decision machine, but he's far from boring to watch. And I think a style like his, with 5-minute rounds, you'd see him work into a lot more stoppages. He's not a one-shot knockout power artist, but he's such a good technical striker that if he's hitting you like this for 5 rounds and then doing it again for 5 rounds in round 2, the chances of you just being worn down by this or just, you know, taking too much damage and ended up taking a knee, those are going to be bigger, you know.
Will he do the Tito Ortiz grave digger if he wins, do you think?
Loading up a little bit more now, right as we started talking about his calmness and precision and patience.
Let's go.
Starting to really let these fly now, isn't he? Nolan's wearing it under that eye. The redness on McCarthy's leg. Nolan might be best served going back to some of those kicks. There we go, some teeps and leg kicks just to sort of keep McCarthy a little bit off boxing range. Drives in for a takedown attempt.
Good defense. Let's go.
McCarthy trying to stuff this takedown attempt. No one's still on that leg.
You know, it's one of the more underutilized single leg defenses, that when a person's head is going off the line past their hip, that the person just stiff arms, keeps a hand on the back of the head to help kill the posture, keeping them down. An awful lot of yups today, Paul. Have you noticed that?
A whole lot, yeah. We've crowded very close to us today.
Yeah, universal sign of agreement.
Let's go, McCarthy.
Oh, beautiful straight right to the body. A little corkscrew motion where he's not leaning into it. Nice right hand over the top there by Nolan, just to keep McCarthy aware that he's still in this fight.
That's a punishing shot there. But it's a punishing shot that's invoked a bigger reaction out of Nolan here now.
Yeah.
Who's nearly like seek and destroy back in exchange for it. But
you can walk onto something when you start getting a bit too aggressive.
I think McCarthy's going to look for a body shot finish here.
Yeah. Yeah. He's varying it up beautifully, isn't he? Faking to go up top and then dipping and with the uppercuts and body shots, hooks to the midriff. Popping that jab out there beautifully, yes, maintaining great control. Right uppercut to the body, left shot to the head. And 3-2 up top. The variety in the shots here are beautiful, and Nolan's in trouble here. He's bleeding heavily as we come down the final 10 seconds of this third round. He's really, really styling on him in this third round, is McCarthy, and it's been big. It's been impressive so far. Three rounds in and we go into the championship rounds. Nolan has a lot to do if he wants to get this fight back in his favour.
Conor McCarthy messaged me this morning asking not to imply that he's bleach blonded Eminem dyed his hair again. I said, would you rather I spread the rumours that you're on sunbeds? So pick your poison, you know.
Yeah.
The hair is looking sharp, though. I'll give him that.
Tell you what, his boxing is looking sharp again. Every fight I see him, he seems to just make massive improvements. And whenever people ask me who are the ones to watch, who are the next ones coming out of the amateur scene into the pro scene that, you know, are ones to keep an eye on, he's the first name.
It'll be exciting to see. And with, you know, Peter Queeley went on a very a well-travelled European route through his career as a fighter. Don't be surprised to see a 48-hour notice trip to Siberia or something like that in Conor McCarthy's future.
Yeah, he's in good hands there, and you know, he's still young. He's 20-21 maybe.
Yeah, I don't think there's a, like, go after the Alexander O'Sullivan, Gary Rooney amateur record, do you know what I mean? Go win an IMAF. You've nothing but time.
Time enough.
Nothing but support as well. Swing and a miss from a crowd member behind us here with a hilarious reference in his head.
Yeah. The confidence, the rhythm, the flow, the power of McCarthy is really on fire here today. There was murmurs of a Sennin Coakley Conor McCarthy fight in December.
Ooh. Could be a title fight on the next show, Paul.
Yeah. After the Sennin's display this evening, I mean, it just gets you excited, doesn't it? McCarthy has that little bit more experience at the moment in mixed martial arts than Sennin, but I mean, if Sennin continues to pick up wins, impressive wins against good opponents, Sennin of course has beaten Conor Nolan here as well, so yeah, they could be a good test for each other.
Let's go, guys. You have him.
I suppose it just depends on where they're going to end up, do you know what I mean? I know that fight earlier on was a middleweight on account of the short notice nature of it, but
yeah.
Conor McCarthy obviously competing at super lightweight here.
Just he's kind of
he's in between the welterweight, lightweight.
Sennin generally
sort of
is a welterweight, so I think it might be a little bit bigger than McCarthy. So it'd be interesting to see if they do that at welterweight. But we'll see. McCarthy now has a handful of belts in different promotions and starting to really make his mark at a couple of weight classes, isn't he? Minute to go now here in round four. Doesn't look like he's slowing down. Nolan
nice
just displaying toughness.
Left. Shovel hooks to the body here from Conor McCarthy. They've landed, they've found a home all night. Just underneath the bottom left rib of Nolan. But
McCarthy fought on your 1, 3, 4 and 5 and now 6. So he's been very busy, especially in this promotion. Some names on his CV. Roman David, Shay Leatham, Alex Connolly, Jess Paolo. Beat Roman David and Shay Leatham over an 8-day period in November, December there recently, and now he's back again. Looking like he's on his way to a big victory here.
And in fairness to both lads here, I know maybe Nolan's feeling a wee bit more tired at this point here due to damage or accumulation of shots, but yeah, both of them seeming incredibly fresh here.
Yeah,
towards the end rounds. of the fourth, going into the fifth.
Yeah, it's been impressive now. Good output. Here we go, round 5.
Come on, Gary! Come on, Ryan! Take him down.
Nolan in desperation mode now. Very likely dropped all 4 rounds so far, the majority of them at least. And McCarthy just maintaining that control of the distance, displaying great accuracy. Unloading now, those shots are coming in, ticking fast. He wants this finish, he wants this statement victory. Nolan covering up well though.
Nolan weathering that storm very well, but Aaron Wallace's eyes are locked onto Conor Nolan here.
You feel a few clean ones now will mean it's the end. Oh, beautiful shot to the body. Nolan's body work has been brilliant tonight.
I think we just got a little bit of the crimson mask onto the desk then here, Paul.
Wouldn't be the first time, Andrew, I've had jackets go to the dry cleaners after some cards to get the blood stains out, but Nolan's still doggedly fighting here and he's playing great heart and he's chasing this takedown attempt. Displayed superb conditioning over these 5 rounds.
Yeah, both of them have, I have to say. That's a nice inside hand position from Conor. You'd wonder the cardio base of both now at the end. Had we have seen more of this throughout the fight, you know?
McCarthy saying he says, doesn't have it.
What?
He's saying he doesn't have it, but we'll see.
Connor, you have it.
He wants to get a finish, he tells us, through the cage here in round 5.
Let's go.
Nolan just won't go away. Displaying great heart. And McCarthy unloading those shots now. Wildly swings hooks. As we come into the last 35 seconds and big knees up the centre to the body of Nolan. Nolan staying right on top of him. Displayed unbelievable levels of heart over these 5 rounds. McCarthy just wants a little bit of separation.
Peter Quealy, advising he's hurt. Yep. Wanting him to swarm for the finish here. We're talking 15 seconds left. Aaron Wallace is looking at it. This could be it. If Conor McCarthy continues this volume, he may get a very late stoppage here.
There we go. Five massive rounds for Conor McCarthy. What a display. And what a display of heart by Conor Nolan.
Yeah,
that was
absolutely
unbelievable.
I have to say, Conor Nolan will be disappointed. His heart is one of the biggest things I've seen. His ability to keep walking forward, and I don't mean to take the punishment, but even be competitive and threatening in some of those exchanges there. It's easy to get run away with certain fighters and say that they are something else, but Conor McCarthy has been nothing but step by step by step impressive every time he's fought in this cage. A very exciting future ahead of him, likely to be, and still. Oh, Decky McLean has the new belt here, actually, in the cage with him. You might notice the blue panel has been replaced with an all gold panel. Main event on the way next.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for both fighters. Five rounds of non-stop action. We go to your judges' scorecards for a decision. Your judges scored this bout 50-45, 50-45, and 50-44 for your winner, and still the new super lightweight champion, Conor McCarthy.